Spire version 3.12 has been released with significant functionality updates in production orders, greater ability to modify sales price levels in large volume, and the capability of entering deposits on purchase orders, and much more. In this version of Spire, new features for processing production order work in process and supporting standard costs have been implemented, giving you greater control over production order builds. If your production orders have many stages prior to the final build, previously you could only mark component inventory as committed when in fact they have been consumed. Now a new optional feature is available to set production order details as work in process and associated with phases. To use this feature, you need to have at least one general ledger account configured for tracking work in process, which can be set as a default in company settings for production orders. Then for every subassembly or component that could be built prior to the overall production build, you would assign a WIP account value on the detail. Additionally, you can assign a phase code to the build phase of a component to determine when this work is done, which in turn inserts the default GL WIP account. Both WIP accounts and build phases can be assigned to production templates if you plan on regularly using work in process whenever you build this manufactured inventory. When you want to process a portion of a production order where a build phase is assigned, the order must have the overall order phase match. Then from the Build button, there is a drop-down from which you can instead select Build Phase. This brings up a screen to confirm which phase is being processed and the build date. Then continue to complete the work in process build, after which the production order will be closed. If the user setting to auto-commit is enabled, remaining components will have quantity marked as committed. When you edit a production order that has had some components built, these will be indicated with a checkmark icon for easy visualization. Also, the WIP Built On field will show the date this was processed. For each component, including those on expanded subassemblies, the quantity will be consumed from the inventory on-hand amount, with a movement transaction having a source of production order. WIP built components can no longer be edited on the order, and note that there is no procedure to reverse a WIP build. The general ledger transaction debits the production WIP account on each component, and credits the respective inventory control accounts, which you can now see on the component list reference, with a transaction type of Work in Pro. When the next phase is ready to complete, you can repeat the build phase procedure for components with the matching phase, including selecting lot or serial numbers for the components when required. And if you use the Next Phase button, this will simply increment the order phase and bypass the build phase process. And you are not required to associate a component with a phase in order to include it in work in process. As long as a WIP account is assigned, you can highlight the row and use the Build Selected button to perform the same procedures as build phase, to consume component quantity and create a ledger transaction. When the production order is ready to build, you can do this in the usual way, determining serial or lot numbers for the finished goods, consuming any remaining components, creating the new inventory quantity, and generating a ledger transaction that nets the production WIP account to zero. In order to track your work in process components, there are two new reports that can be found on a brand new Reports tab within Production Orders. For a desired date range, you can print reports to list components already processed and grouped either by order number or by the ledger WIP account for the purpose of reconciling these details to the accounting. There are many other useful changes related to production orders. A significant update is the ability to support the use of component inventory standard costs when building production orders, instead of the inventory cost, often desired when more precise budgeting for manufacturing is required to track profitability, and production that varies from standard cost is more easily seen. There is a new company setting for production orders to set the cost method to any of inventory, current, or standard cost, and when not using the actual inventory cost, the differential cost account becomes active to indicate where cost differences will be posted. On production orders, the component costs are based in this company setting, unless that cost is zero, in which case the inventory cost will be used. Building the order will use these cost values to calculate the unit cost for the assembled inventory. In the ledger transaction, the differential account contains the variance. Also note that this window now supports the View Source button, opening either the production history record for completed builds, or the production order for work in process transactions. The icons at the left that indicate availability have been changed to have different shapes as well as colors, to more easily identify them when color on its own wasn't clear enough. The assembly item and subassembly components now have a gear icon attached instead of being a square shape. There are now separate buttons for open target for highlighted component purchase orders and open source for the highlighted assembly item for better clarity when taking these actions. And for higher volume entry, the import tool now supports production orders and templates for quickly creating new orders from an external source, with rules for how to set the production order numbers and using sequence values for subassembly components. In Spire version 3.11, a new way to manage customer price levels was introduced to allow for unlimited named levels and the ability to create future prices without affecting current pricing. This update improves on price level maintenance by being able to selectively hide historical or future prices and either create or edit multiple price levels in a single procedure. When editing a single inventory item record, the Prices and Units tab now has new buttons to show historical or future prices. These are based on each level effective dates. When you toggle a button, this will either reveal or hide the records. And when both are hidden, this will leave only the current price for each level. Also new from here is the ability to edit any of the margin or markup values directly in the grid and recalculate the sell price. Note also that the Details tab is now the place to locate the Levy field. Changes have also been made to the way large volume maintenance can be performed. In addition to importing cell prices from an Excel spreadsheet, you can now access the Cell Levels tab to make large-scale modifications. Perhaps you might multi-select rows from the grid, either consecutive or not. Perhaps you have predefined filters to list a subgroup of price levels, and from here you can select some or all of them. However you choose, when you click the Change Price button, you now have the choice to create new future prices based on these selections, or modify the prices of these selected records. Whichever choice you make, the screen that appears will look similar for setting prices. At the top is a place where you could set all price level records to have the same level code, effective date, or specific sell price. Or instead of a specific price, you can use the set margin or set markup functions to calculate prices based on the respective costs, or change existing prices based on a percentage increase or decrease. And if prices need to be rounded to have two decimals or specific precision, the Round Price button has a list of many choices, including two new choices to round to the nearest whole dollar or 5 cents. Additionally, you can make edits to specific prices directly in the grid, either from the Sell Price cell or any of the cost margins or markups. When creating new records, if you have selected multiple price levels for the same item and unit, but with different effective dates, you should use the Remove Conflicts button to ensure only one price level is listed for each item and unit. Choosing to continue from this screen will generate the determined price updates or level creations from this list. In previous versions of Spire, recording a deposit amount for a vendor had to be entered as an unapplied payment in accounts payable and would not be connected to a purchase order. In this release, purchase deposits can now be entered directly on orders and posted values are visible here. After a purchase order has been issued and before anything has been received, the Invoice button acts as the place for deposit entry. The field Actual Vendor Invoice Amount will represent the deposit value instead of the invoice value. You can use the vendor invoice number as a deposit reference, and the invoice date as the deposit date. Generally, you would not require terms and due date, and any calculated tax will be ignored here. When this is posted, rather than a vendor payment being created, instead, a vendor debit transaction is generated, which in effect is a pre-invoice debit amount to which a payment can later be applied. The accounts payable control account is credited, and a purchase deposit clearing account that you must set up in company settings is debited. When the purchase order is open, the vendor debit transaction can be seen from the accounts payable tab here, or also from the accounts payable module for the vendor. However you choose to display this list, the vendor payment is then entered in the usual manner, where this is applied to the vendor debit rather than an invoice. When this payment is posted, the usual accounting occurs with the accounts payable control account debited and thus netting to zero, and the payment bank account is credited. When you next edit the purchase order, the deposit amount appears at the right side in the order details section, whether or not the payment has yet been posted in accounts payable. This is a reminder that the deposit posted successfully. Receiving inventory for the purchase continues to work the same way, either for a partial or complete receipt of goods. After receiving the stock, the difference comes when creating the vendor invoice and the associated general ledger transaction. Entry of the invoice information remains the same, but the deposit remaining is displayed, which might be the full deposit amount, or perhaps reduced by previously posted partial invoices. When this is posted, the purchase deposit account is credited and thus nets to zero, and any difference between the deposit and invoice totals credits the accounts payable control account. At this point, the net accounting is the same as if the purchase was invoiced and the payment was later applied. If you use the Spire web application for mobile access, you will find a number of new improvements in displaying lists, processing sales orders, and accessing information in inventory records. On all lists, it is now possible to configure which columns you want to show and hide and have this selection remembered for future use, from an expanded list of choices. This includes sorting this list by a column, and also positioning columns on the grid, and a new Reset View button will restore all columns to the factory defaults. Where a key is associated with the list, this column will be pinned to the left side by default. These columns will stay in place as you scroll from left to right. If desired, you could instead pin it to the right, or remove the pin, or include other columns to pin on either side. Particularly in inventory records, there are more sections of data available to view and edit. You can now view price levels and units of measure, and view or edit UPC codes, serial or lot numbers if enabled, sales statistics, and any additional accessories for sales orders. And user-defined fields can be seen for many different records and transactions, not only to see or edit, but also to view or modify the configuration properties. And you can also maintain the price level and product codes records with a more familiar organization as compared to desktop. If you would like more information about Spire Accounting, access the link in the description below to our homepage. Read the online manual help for additional assistance. Watch more videos from this playlist. And subscribe to the Spire YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.